Tasha, aka Pumpkin. So we are for to get ready to take these twists down and refresh them. And I need a good wash. My hair is not per se dry, but it needs some loving. I feel like it needs some love. I can tell when my hair needs some love. So let's get this started. So I am back with my hair products I'm going to use. I keep a drawer with all my hair products and other stuff in here. Like, it's the little plastic drawer. I'm glad I got that beside me. Because what you're going to need, but what I use, if you want to try what I use on my hair, I like this new shampoo and conditioner right here. Yep. Both of them say the same thing, basically. It's just, I got to turn them upside down. I mean, right side up. It is, both say cream of nature pure honey. And both of them are new. I tried the other new one, which was the one that had the clay in it. And it was pretty good, too. I liked it, those two. I felt like the shampoo really cleaned my hair and scalp really good. And when I shampoo, I put it on my roots and massage it in and try not to do the ends, because the ends are the oldest parts of your hair. So you don't want to dry that out even more. But that's the point of having, you know, a leave-in condition. And shampoo is like, it helps. I don't do co-washes too much. Because I feel like I really like a clean head. And a co-wash doesn't really do too much for me. For others it may, but not for me. So, yeah, I'm for the use these two right here. Both of them say for dry, dehydrated hair. It's a moisturizing, dry defense. No sulfates or minerals, which is good. And they say mineral oil is bad for your hair. Well, and I am going instead, I want to use a detangler, but I say I might as well use my leave-in conditioner. Because it's light, it's not thick. This is thick, but it's not too thick. It's like a thick cream, and I love thick creams because I feel like that's what really moisturizes my hair. But sometimes I use just this after I wash my hair, and it'll feel good. But I won't just use this alone. I would always use any oil, or both. Anything like a moisturizer or anything like that. Because, get that out of the way. I use, you know, black castor oil. Jamaican black castor oil. Let me correct myself because I don't want nobody to come for me. Yes, ma'am, and yes, sir. Yeah, I use this. And it's pretty thick when you, like, as you can see, but when it's hot in your house and warm, it ain't thick now. But when it's when it was cold, it was just thick and it was hard to come out. I will always have to set it by here to like get it out. But I really put this on my scalp and I put a little bit on my hair. That's why my hair is still shiny, because my hair loves this stuff. But I will always use this and this. Or I will always use, give me one moment, a twisting cream with this, anything, always with this, creams, butters, all that, this, because my hair loves it, duh. So, I plan on using my leave-in and trying this, because, smells good. Yeah, I haven't tried this No, I just really just bought this and haven't tried it at all. Technically. And it is a grapeseed styling shine recipe. It's called Ice Curls. It's glossy curling jelly. So, let me see. You don't think you want to know that. Okay. It says formulated with grape seed, or I ain't gonna read you the whole thing because that would be boring. It says formulated with grape seed or marshmallow root and almond oil. This recipe hydrates, softens, and makes waves, curls, and coils more manageable to prep and style. Other added benefits include helping diminish the shrinkage, minimizing frizz, which I do want to minimize frizz, but I also love frizz because it gives me volume when I want to do like a twist out or something like that. But I haven't did a twist out in a minute. Or a braid out, because I love braid outs too. And reducing the need for multiple styling products. So, I'm the type of girl that doesn't use a lot of products on my head because I hate a product buildup. And I like to make my wash days last longer. I will always prolong it. That's one thing about me. And if I would want to refresh my twist, since it says it softens and hydrates, we will test that out. And I will come back to you and refresh my twist. So, this is all I'm gonna use. I'm gonna get ready to wash my hair and I will see you soon. As you can see, I still look a little crazy. And I have my hair in these twists and they section out and everything. So, I will start twisting my hair using this, what I told you about previously, and yeah, sometimes what I say about this, since it already has like almond oil and stuff like that in it, I'm not gonna put oil on my hair. And besides, my hair is already shiny anyway from the conditioner leave-in. So I will just use this for my scalp, on my scalp. So I will start at the back. I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna do my hair. Now, guys, I'm gonna let you know this is a protective style, so we plan on keeping our hair protected, right? Right. So, I'm gonna untwist this twist, finger comb my back section of my hair, and I don't even think I want to use a comb, no way. And I'm not going to try to make them too small because I don't want them too small. This time I want them kind of smallish, medium. And I'm going to take this. This is how much I'm using. Start from my ends, and it's supposed to be moisturizing to my roots, but I'm not gonna get too close because I don't. Because usually, when you do that, you get product buildup, and we're gonna see how this product works on my hair. And it glides really good. I like that. It feels like a gel, like my olive oil gel I like to use. And it clumps my curls up really good. I tell you that, I do like that. Shook. It clumps my curls up really good. I like that. This right here is my hair texture. It clumps my curls up really good. I feel like it really does that. I wouldn't do it as a wash and go, because I do have some parts that just don't want to act right. But my hair does curl up, as you can see. And this is what I mean when my hair texture is looser at the back. You don't see the difference. So what we're going to do is take that. Brush this through. Because my hair is still damp, but some parts are still drier than others. And we're gonna do this. You're gonna take it, and you're gonna take your hair, and you're gonna two strand twist, just like that. And I twist relatively fast because I'm always doing my hair. So yeah, my hair is all the way down here, reaching towards my collarbone. So this is the first twist, and many more to go. Section is pretty dry, so take a small section, clamp that out the way, get your water as needed, spritz it, brush your hair through, get your product, start into roots. Some of it's on my top, so I use that too. This section feels like it's a little too big, so I am going to do that. I feel like this is good for really twists. This twist really tight through, and to make this last very long, you have to twist really tight in order for your twist to last long. So I'm gonna repeat this a few more times. Twirl your hair and it will puff out and look how it's looking. So take the chip, twist my hair. Get up closer. Try to around my finger and I let go. So these are my first few twists. And I say it's gonna look pretty good. I'm gonna show you one last time. Take a section of my hair, at my chill. Call me through. Okay. It doesn't. And also, I noticed it curls my hair, but not like my olive oil does. Because for my olive oil, I feel like it's much thicker. It's not as thick as my olive oil gel. It doesn't really, because my roots look a little puffy, but my hair from here, it's curly. And I let go. And this is a close-up of my twist, so I will come back and show you what my head looks like halfway done so far. Okay, I am back, and this is sort of like halfway how far my hair looks so far. And as you can see, they are so juicy and pretty with the little curl at the end. And this white residue is gonna, you know, dry. It's not gonna stay there. Still have some movement. Did the other side. If I can get it right. You know how I am. I'm using my phone. So. And I will come back when I am fully finished. I also came back to show you. This is my curl pattern in the front. It's loose. It's always been the loosest texture in the front. It always been loose. Like, my hair in the front always been loose. So, it's like the middle part is very thick and kinky and curly. Really tight. And then the front is like all over the place. Because I got like a whole bunch of different curls everywhere. So this is my finished results, and I have to tell you, I am in love with this. Like, look at the shine and the movement. Like, it can't get no better than this. This is super cute. And what I'm going to do is put my bonnet on. So what I do at nighttime to keep my twists nice and good looking, I put my bonnet on, which is this right here. And in the morning, I got this little turban with the little bow. I'm gonna put that on. Got my little edge done. I put bobby pins up here because I don't want hair in my face. Yep. Ain't this cute? See? I got a bond. And this will turn into a bond twist out. If you want to do a twist out, I will do a twist out within this because I plan on keeping this up for a good week and a half or 2 weeks to keep my hands out of my head. So for to show you what this looks like in my head. Okay, here's one way I would wear this turban. This gave me a good idea of how I should wear my turban. This is so cute. What do y'all guys think? I think it's cute. And so, guys, another way I would do this, I would tuck all my twists underneath and hide my hair, because when I go to work, I don't want to have my hair out and stuff, because I already explained, you know, COVID-19. I work at a nursing home, so you got to keep yourself covered and be safe. That's all I got to say. Other than this, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you guys think, and let me know what else would you want me to do. Other than that, it was nice seeing you again. Bye-bye.